All right, today we are going to talk about blood. This is going to be a nice and short lecture. All right, blood. So, just a little bit of information about blood. Remember we talked about types of tissue and one of those types being connective tissue? Remember that blood is a type of fluid connective tissue. All right, so when we think about blood, we really have to think about it as a bunch of different types of cells floating in something called plasma, which is like the fluid that they're floating in. So it's cells in plasma, and essentially this forms a liquid matrix. Now, let's break down the cells a little bit more. So, types of cells. The first type we're going to talk about is red blood cells. But the anatomical or scientific name are erythrocytes. Red blood cells, and sometimes we'll abbreviate it as RBC. Now, the purpose is to carry oxygen using hemoglobin to do so. That's pretty much all you need to know about erythrocytes. And one last thing is that they're the most numerous or kind of most common in the blood. So the blood is filled with mostly red blood cells. All right, that's our first type of cell. Our second type of cell, which is actually the second most numerous, are thrombocytes. And that's a fancy name for platelets. Now, the purpose of that is to clot. Oops. CLOT, clot blood. And they are the second most numerous. Now let's talk about the last type of cell in blood. And we've kind of been going from most numerous to least numerous. So again, this is going to be the least numerous here. This third type of cell in the blood are called leukocytes. Which are white blood cells, or WBC. The purpose of these is to fight infections, and defend the body against foreign materials of any kind. Now, leukocytes are a little bit more complex than the other types of blood cells, just because there are a bunch of different types. So we're going to talk about the five different types together. The first one is neutrophils. The second is lymphocytes. The third is monocytes. The fourth is basophils. And the last type is eosinophils. And that wraps up our discussion of blood and what it is composed of and the purpose of each thing that it's composed of.